guys' cartel here. So, many of you may know the notorious figure Boogie2988. I mean, from the beginning of his career, which I known him as Francis when I first knew about Boogie2988. He was Francis, he was the guy who was just always angry. He was always, you know, getting angry about food or Mountain Dew, Dr. Pepper, stuff of that nature, video games, stuff like that. I think the first video I encountered was his Christmas video. So, as you know, time has gone on, you know, the apples have rotten, you know, the trees have grown, and we're in the present. Boogie has found a liking to be misleading his claims about his health. As you know, Boogie is a big guy. He's not a small guy. And so with that, you do get a lot of health complications. Even if you're too skinny, you'll get health complications. So one health complication that Boogie claimed to have was that he had cancer. Now, you know, cancer is a big claim to have. It's one of the biggest you could possibly have. I mean, it's like the all Hail Mary in diseases nearly. Besides, you know, diseases that are completely fatal. You know, you can't joke about cancer. You can't. You can't lie about it. So what we come to find is that Boogie2988 was actually being a complete liar about the situation. Nearly pathological. So he found himself in some serious hot water. And if that wasn't enough, the podcast that he's on, Lolcow, made him get a tattoo on his face that says liar. So let's dive deep into this insane situation. So he went on to talk about his supposed struggle, the treatment plans, and even got sympathy from fans. People were actually donating money to him, you know, because your favorite, you know, somebody you look up to or you idolize is going through something serious, and so you want to help them. But here's the kicker. People started to notice inconsistencies in his story. As Boogie2988 kept pushing this cancer story, other creators began to dig deep, and they started noticing that it just didn't add up. People were asking for proof, medical records, anything that could confirm his diagnosis. And then, boom, the truth came out. It was all a lie. Boogie didn't have cancer, and the entire story was a fabrication. And so we got CoffeeZilla. Shout out to CoffeeZilla. We're leaving the video down in the description. If you want to watch his video, you can go there and watch it. And he has an entire video dissecting, talking with Boogie about him lying about the situation.
YouTuber we accused of a crypto scam just got accused of faking cancer.
You are faking your cancer diagnosis, Boogie.
Despite being offered a total of $80,000 to prove everyone wrong if he could show his diagnosis to a private third party, he refused to do so, which is annoying because publicly he uses his cancer as a shield from any wrongdoing. In fact, when I confronted Boogie on his crypto scam, that's one of the reasons he used.
I'm in pretty dire need of money. I have a lot of medical bills and I'm fighting cancer.
And more specifically, why he had to promote the coin and couldn't pay back $5,000.
The money's already spent. It's at Mercy Hospital right now. It's gone. I used it to pay debts.
I'll be honest. I have no idea if Boogie is faking cancer. I also don't understand why he wouldn't just show it if he had a diagnosis, but either way, we won't know without an actual doctor involved. So I won't speculate on that, but what I can do is confront Boogie on this second claim, the cancer and medical bills, because I found out a few days ago that these statements were false. I know this because Boogie gave us a timeline of when he got paid in the first place. So when were you paid the $5,000?
5 days ago.
Later, I verified with Boogie this payment occurred on June 19th, and when Boogie said all the money was gone on
it's almost six, laughably
that
like
gives us a window of time.
It's just like so hysterical.
For about $5,000 of medical expenses. Boogie,
so obvious. How do you get caught in that easy ass lie? Like, he didn't even try to hide it.
Him providing accurate records, which I know is a dubious idea, but when he shared what he had, it fell far short of even what I was expecting. He gave me two receipts for the time period, one for $154, the other for a copay of $60, a total of $214 by the time we talked. So where did the rest of the money go? Well, Boogie claimed that it was really intended for medical expenses after we spoke, and that when he said that
he
meant it colloquially and then accused me of lying. Wait, that's on June 28th. That's on June 28th. You showed me a payment for $550 on June 28th, which is after we talked, after you told me the money was all gone.
Yes! Have you never heard of the colloquial system? Yeah, that money's all gone. It's all spent. I have a specific thing I need to do with it. Have you never heard that colloquialism? Use fucking Google then! It's very common!
I'm saying...
I'm not used to this level of scrutiny! it's like old Boogie.
It's like Francis.
Because looking back at what Boogie said, it wasn't just the money's gone, which already means very specifically the money's gone, but he also says the money's at Mercy Hospital right now, which is a colloquialism I've never heard before. If you mean it's not at Mercy Hospital,
it's at Mercy Hospital right now.
But even being as charitable as I can, adding in everything he calls medical expenses outside of our time window, like there was an $1,000 credit card payment. Okay, we'll just say that's medical, right? He's still only able to get me to about $2,500 worth of medical expenses for the month, most of it not to Mercy Hospital, which I wondered about. Did he need the fatty coin then? From where I was sitting, instead of having spent the money on medical bills, it looked like he saved most of it because of his starting and ending bank balances for the month. Wait, you paid about $2,500. Like you're also talking about money you haven't spent, which you're trying to add up to $3,000. That's not the $5,000 you said was gone. And then you're taking.
Well, I told you it was $4,000 when we started this conversation, but of course you're lying about that too.
Boogie, can you explain?
And he's accusing him of a liar.
You started the month with $800, ended it with $5,000, and you're saying the $5,000 you made from a crypto scam has nothing to do with it.
Oh my gosh, man, that is too fucking funny, man. Boogie is hilarious. I'm not gonna lie. Like, he's yelling in the mic. He's fucking furious about getting caught in a lie. He just accused CoffeeZilla of being a liar when he's just exposing the truth. He's just giving dates. Yeah, time doesn't lie. I don't know. It's just hilarious. Like his fight. You know, it's like he get caught. He's gotten the lie, and he's just full. Like he's going for. He's fully going for it. Eventually, does give in. And you know, he gets the tattoo. Which, let's look at that. Let's look at the tattoo that he gets. It's insane.
Look at this. Look at this. Does this look infected to you? A lot of people are saying it's not real because it didn't look infected like 3 seconds after it got it. It's now been 24 hours. It looks infected. Sammy doesn't like it.
No.
And now, oh my God. A lot of people are asking me if I want to grow my beard out over it. And yeah, it's kind of why I put it here. But put your fingers right here.
It kind of does look like sideburn beard. Like for a second it did.
Because I don't. Because it's smooth.
Like if he had a sideburn beard, it could work.
Coming back, by the way, I'm a 50-year-old man with a face tattoo now.
Yeah.
Yesterday was my birthday. I turned 50.
Wait,
this is how
fuck?
I spend my birthday, everybody.
Oh my gosh, look at his nose hair. It's like the most nose hair I've ever seen. He says like the most nose hair I've ever seen. Look at that shit. Jeez. That shit is in there.
I deserve it. I get it. I
am I tripping, or is like the mustache going in the nose?
I have to go see my doctor.
It's like,
he's gonna ask what this
like
is
cut
about.
It. It's growing.
And I still have this disease. And I still
wait, is that the nose hair, or is that a? I can't even tell,
so
bro.
So that's fun. How do I look? How you tell me truth?
Wait, is that his?
Look?
That is his nose hair. They're like
I
peeking
think you're
out.
Adorable still.
Ew.
Very attractive.
Jesus Christ.
And I think you're brave, but I also. Right thing to do.
Yeah, I didn't want to do it. I obviously didn't want to do it. I still wish I hadn't done it, except the fact that I didn't want to do it is why I did it, because like I fucked up, right? I get it. And I'll tell you what I learned about all of
me
this
when I'm spiraling.
Shut the fuck up about my trauma and my history and all that shit.
Yelling?
It's played the fuck out. Nobody wants to hear about it. Nobody cares. I need to figure out how to be entertaining on YouTube again.
Yeah, you do.
I don't know what that even looks like.
No, this is entertaining.
It's been so long since I tried. Liar. I may as well say Lolcow. I have branded myself a Lolcow for life. Gee, I just... dumbest thing I've ever done. Except, you know, just exaggerating and talking about my disease without getting a full diagnosis of cancer and then calling it cancer, even though it's probably cancer and I still might have cancer. Now I have to go. How do you explain this to your doctor? He watches my videos, by the way. He knows all. He's gonna know all.
His doctor watches his videos. GG's, man. Wrap it up.
It is what it is. I thought it would make people on the internet.
It is what it is, bro. So as you see there, obviously, he's got a lot going on. Okay, he's got a lot of nose hairs. If you look, that's a lot. He needs to get one of those little like muscle, like those little tweezer thingies or whatever, like the little spinny rotating. Get them bitches out. You know how many boogers are probably in there? Like, regardless though. Okay, so he's got, you know, he got the face tat. Was forced to, but it gets even crazier because now the face tat is actually like rotting on his face and it's like fucking corroding. Like, as you saw, it was like kind of rotting and people were thinking that like it was like infected, but like now it's fading. So some people are speculating that it's like one of those like fake, because there's like these fake tattoos you can get where they're like they last for like, I think they last for like 75 days or something like that. Around that time you can get like a fake tattoo where like it's kind of permanent, but it's like temporarily permanent. And so following all this crazy shit happening, we get another crazy reaction.
It did not work.
In the podcast that he runs with Keemstar, he finds out that he's not getting paid for the month. And so he has a mental breakdown. You know, he gets into his mode. And this is what transpires.
Okay, calm down for a second.
No. Give me like $4,000 from charity back at
the internet.
Got money, bro. Calm down.
I don't even.
No, you're not.
Blowing out.
Jordy, did you hear what he just said?
What? That we're taking your money? We are taking your money.
You
can't get paid in the month of August for faking cancer. Are you serious?
Yes, I'm serious, dude. You tried to buy me off of the show. You fired me. We tore up that contract. Team, I donated $4,000 of my money to charity. My bank account's pretty much at zero right now. I don't even have enough to get through this month. What's going to happen to me on August 1st, team?
Okay, okay, calm down for a second.
What's going to happen to me on August 1st? My mortgage is due. My health insurance is due.
Calm down.
Let's go. This is great.
It would be incredibly unethical for you to get paid on our best month ever because you faked cancer.
I already gave the money away. I was hoping to get some of it back, but I already donated $4,000 of that paycheck to charity. It's already on cancer charity's hands. Now what am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to do? I have a $2,000 mortgage hitting the third. I have health insurance. I have lecture. You want me to be on this show? I have that lights. I have the.
It's my.
I'm gonna pay for it. I'll send you a screen cap. I'm like.
Microphone is going in and out.
Dude, calm down.
This is.
Are you even thinking about this? Why should you make money faking cancer? That's insane. Like, we can't do that.
You're out of your mind. You're out of your dude, I can't be homeless.
The good news, Boogie, is banks will work with you.
No, they fucking. Well, you want me to be able to live stream? If I don't have internet, if I don't have power, if I don't have electricity, if I don't have running water, if I can't live in a house, how would I be on this show? You make that make sense, genius?
Do you want to even understand how this looks?
It's gold. It's so good. It's so good. Like,
you want me to be on the show? I have to be able to pay my mortgage.
I know. Calm down. Calm down.
I have to pay my
okay. Calm down. What do you think?
I have to pay my light bill.
What do you think this whole chat is thinking right now? All right. Oh, Boogie wants to profit off of faking cancer. Oh, Boogie wants to
pay $4,000 sippy cup. Sippy sip. Back, and I'll be able to make it through the month.
Oh, so give you the $4,000 back to charity, so it's not even really giving it to charity.
As you see there, Boogie's obviously, you know, not very happy that for the month he's not getting paid because he lied about having cancer. And then he sucked up a bunch of money, not only from using a crypto scam to make money from his audience and take advantage of them, but he also used cancer as a deploy, as a divergent to garner a bunch of fucking cash. Crazy, right? And after that, the backlash was felt immediately. Fans felt betrayed, and the internet exploded with anger. Lying about something that serious is a huge deal. And people weren't gonna just skim over it. Like, nobody's gonna just pretend as if nothing just happened. You know, Boogie's not off the hook. And it wasn't just fellow fans who were mad about it. It was content creators as well, calling him out, going in calls. I'm like, bro, like, why are you lying about cancer? You don't have cancer. Or if he doesn't have cancer, which he possibly could, he has like a type of cancer that's like not even fatal, or it's like not even the, not that it's not fatal, it's not like the worst cancer. Like, out of all the cancers possible, the cancer that he has is the cancer you want. It's like the most minimal. It's like, you know, people like, they say like it's people who like, they just like, they have like skin cancer, but like sometimes the skin cancer is like not that bad. I think herpes is a form of skin cancer, if I believe. Don't quote me on that, okay? Don't quote me on that. But I think herpes is a type of skin cancer, or like a cold. Oh no 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 no. That's wrong. That's wrong. It's a cold sore is a type of herpes. That's what it's. Not a cancer. Not a cancer. Okay. But I think that there are types of cancer that are like not too bad. Obviously, it's cancer. You don't want it. But you get what I mean. I'm tripping. You know, it's late. Okay, give me a break.
Boogie tonight in the podcast.
But it didn't stop there. Boogie is a part of Lolcow, and you know, let's just say they didn't let him off easy. In a bizarre twist, the host made him get a tattoo. Lie. The podcast, you know, they took it to the next level, and now he's branded to be a liar for life. But in fact, turns out the tattoo is fading. So what we initially may have thought, oh, it was, you know, that he was just gonna have this tattoo forever. Turns out it's not gonna be forever, or that's like somehow it's fading. I don't know if he got one of those like fake ones, or yeah, there's like the 72, or like, I think it's like, it's either like, you can get the, I think it's like different ones. You can get one that lasts like 3 years and it fades away. You can get one that lasts for like a year that fades away. You can get one that lasts like 3 months and it fades away. There's just like types of like ways that you can make it last for longer. And I think he may have got one of those, but I mean, it's only been like a week or two. Like, he must've got like something that's like barely even gonna stay, or it's like fully infected and it's just corroding and it's just like, ugh, it's just like fading off his skin. It's like, ugh. And obviously now, if you've seen like the videos that, you know, that we reacted to, and his reaction to it, it's been a mix of like anger, regret, defiance, always defiance. You know, he's gone to several rants about, you know, trying to explain why he did it, and his points just seem like the damage is already done, bro. The damage is already done. The face is just a constant reminder of the fact that he's a liar. GG's, bro. You know, his reputation is gonna take a hit, but honestly, I don't think people care that much. I think people care about the fact that he took money. I think that's more of the thing that people are like, why the fuck would you do that? But you know, it is what it is, and it sucks that it happened. You know, the whole situation with Boogie tonight is just wild. You know, from lying cancer, lying about, you know, his face, or like lying about cancer, having his face tattooed, he's not getting paid for this month because Lolcow podcast or whatever, they stripped him of the payment. He said, fuck that shit, you're gone, buddy. You know, it's a crazy story that's left the internet in shock. And you know, whether you're a fan of Boogie or not, it's hard to look at this as like not feeling like cross, like you just got crossed over, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, the whole Lolcow podcast is just, it's crazy. Like, you gotta see it. There's so much happening constantly. There's people coming in calls. It's just so much happening. And Boogie2988 is always just going off every single time. It's really a meta. You know, it's a meta, bro. But what do you think about the situation? You know, what do you think about him lying about cancer and having to get a face tattoo that's basically corroding his face off? And what do you think about the Lolcow podcast? Leave your thoughts about them in the description or in the comments down below. And do you think that the punishment for lying about cancer, you know, him getting a tattoo, was deserved? And as always, you know, like the video, subscribe. You're gonna have to do it anyways. I'm telling you, you're going to have to subscribe. It's inevitable. You know you want to subscribe. I know you want to subscribe. Just subscribe. Make sure you press that button so you never miss out on all the juicy videos that we got lined up for you. You're gonna have, I'm telling you right now, I'm not going anywhere. you're not going anywhere. Just press the button, bro. Just press it. We're at 156 right now. We're close to 200. Okay. At 200, we'll have a special video. Just press the button and we'll do something good for you. So, make sure to hit that bell so you have all the notifications on for more crazy stories that we cover on the internet and everything that's going on with these crazy people. With that being said, I'll see you in the next video.